Today we are going to visit several time periods in our planet. Let's travel through different eras, where the main masters of the Earth, not just dinosaurs, but the most toothy dinosaurs. For dinosaurs, teeth and claws were the most important tools of survival. Without teeth, it would have been impossible for ancient lizards to survive. So how did the creatures that were among the first to inhabit our Earth get their teeth? The first vertebrates had no teeth and they, like the lamprey of today, may do with horny growths on their tongues. Today it is believed that teeth evolved over 400 million years ago from the tubercles of covering plates on the jaws of primitive fish. It is likely that at first the teeth were not rooted and sort of peeled off outward and were displaced from the inside by younger teeth. However, in bony fish and terrestrial vertebrates, the teeth are in the recesses of the jaw, and in order for them to fall out, it is necessary to dissolve their bases. A similar thing happens in humans when milk teeth are replaced by permanent ones. The ancestors of the jawbreakers, scientists have named them Rhodotini. The fishes can be considered the first founders of the toothy smile. This species existed a long time ago. Of course, they could not be called full-fledged teeth. Most likely, it was only the embryo of full-fledged teeth, but as they say, it was a beginning and the result will come in time. Time passed by. Time and air passed each other. Several mass extinctions passed into eternity. And then came the Mesozoic era, the age of dinosaurs and mammals. This is where an abundance of different creatures could compete with each other in the number and size of their jaws. Teeth are small as a needle and big as modern kitchen knives. Here we will stop and talk a bit about the owners of the largest, small and most unusual teeth. The teeth and dinosaurs were very diverse. Size and shape of the teeth depended on the lifestyle of the lizards and their preferences. The sharp and straight teeth of meat-eating dinosaurs work like spears. The predator would set its prey in the tooth and then either tear it to pieces or swallow, and right away. The teeth anchored in the jaw are adapted for active fighting, so they are characteristic of dinosaurs who prefer to hunt large prey. Teeth with an erased upper surface or sharpened indicate a vegetarian preference. Dinosaurs' teeth with a scooping element were used for snipping leaves. Our old acquaintance, Tyrannosaurus. Have you ever wondered why a Tyrannosaurus looks intimidating? The answer is obvious. Its massive sharp teeth are frightening and terrifying. By the size, shape, curvature, wear and other details of the teeth, you can determine what and how the lizard feed, as well as how it interacted with other animals and plants within its ecosystem. Tyrannosaurus were huge carnivorous lizards. They needed large amounts of meat for sustenance, so they hunted large dinosaurs. Tyrannosaurus' fangs were D-shaped and had special reinforcing ridges. The Tyrannosaurus' fangs were bent inside the jaw to make it easier to grasp the prey. Tyrannosaurus' fangs are considered the largest of all land predators, including the root. They may have been as long as 30 centimeters. Terrestrial carnivorous Spinosaurus possessed enormous teeth. On the front part of the jaw of a 15 meters long dinosaurs weighing 7 tons, there were 7 or 8 pairs of sharp conical teeth. Behind the front fence were another 20 or 30 smaller teeth. Spinosaurus teeth could be up to 15 centimeters long. Spinosaurus feed on fish, so their fangs were smooth and allowed you to string the fish on them as a spear. When a fish was cut, the Spinosaurus would immediately swallow it. Despite its small size, Dromaeosaurus's teeth allowed it to tear flesh from its victims, which was much larger than a 2-meter-long Dromaeosaurus. The predator's fangs resembled a saw. During the hunt, the Dromaeosaurus plunged its teeth into the flesh of its prey and then turned and its head sharply sideways, ripping out a piece of flesh. A dagger-like, serrated fangs are characteristic of both active predators and scavengers. Because of its impressive teeth, the carnivorous Carcharodontosaurus, as large as Tyrannosaurus, was named Sharp-Toothed Lizard. Unlike the fangs of Tyrannosaurus, the fangs of Carcharodontosaurus were not reinforced and resembled huge razors. The jaws of the predator were weaker than those of Tyrannosaurus, which was compensated by the length of the fangs and their specific shape. The teeth of this lizard resembled those of a white shark, long convex on the sides with sharp edges. The jaws of Allosaurus contained approximately 64 teeth, which gradually decreased in size as they approached the pharynx. If you compare the skull of an Allosaurus with the of a Tyrannosaurus, that Allosaurus teeth are proportionately smaller. Allosaurus could open their jaws very wide and possibly use the short teeth in their jaws like saw teeth and take out chunks of flesh using a cutting motion with the entire head. The teeth of the Diplodocus and Spinosaurus, on the other hand, resembled a palisade or a rake. They were not suitable for chewing food. The rake teeth were used by the lizard to rip and tear off foliage. Food was digested in the gastrointestinal tract. Its teeth were similar to those of a chisel or spoon. Sauropods did not chew their food, tearing it off with chisel-like teeth and swallowing it immediately. Food was crushed in the stomach with the help of gastrolithic stones. How did this happen? Simply the lizard would swallow smooth stones and the food would be grinded to mush between the stones. But for example, there were up to 800 teeth in the mouth of the Triceratops. In the jaw claws, the teeth clamped together, cutting and grinding the food into pieces. Triceratops plucked plant food with its beak. Triceratops' pruning shears were constantly renewed. Their teeth grew from 36 to 40 rows in each part of the jaw. The Diplodocus had approximately 40 small, peg-like teeth arranged together at the front of the jaw. These long and thin teeth were replaced at the rate of one tooth every 35 days. The apex of the tooth formed a rounded triangle, which helped to separate the foliage from the longer sections of branches in one single action. Diplodocus ate constantly, stopping food and take only for a night's rest. This is why its teeth wore out and fell out very quickly, but in place on the old teeth, new ones grew instantly. Let's move Antisea lizards. Ichthyosaurs had sharp conical teeth. Each of them was located and separate well, like, for example, in modern sperm whales. It is as if that, during the course of life, new teeth repeatedly fell out, replacing them. Plesiosaurus teeth are distinctive and recognizable, not rounded, but triangular in cross-section with cutting edges. This structure allowed them hunt their prey or enemy, very effectively increasing the blood flow to the victim. The wounded animal was quickly weakened by the great loss of blood. Liopleurodents. Liopleurodents had rounded teeth. The powerful jaw of the lizard acted as a so-called press. The prey was under incredible pressure and the end was inevitable. Some pterosaurs were toothless, such the Quetzalcoatls, pterodons, and edgearchids. Other dinosaur species had teeth. Early pterosaurs often had teeth that differed in structure from other pterosaur species. For example, some had teeth on the palate. In later groups of pterosaurs, the front teeth were often longer, forming a prey grab. At the transversely expanded tips of the jaws, by the size and position, varied greatly from species to species. The teeth were located each in their own well, and when the teeth changed, they grew from behind rather than from below. Istiodactyls had curved teeth for eating meat, but Sitanochasmatids used jaws with numerous needle-like teeth as a filter to separate captured underwater life from water. Pterodactyls had more than 1,000 bristly teeth, and the teeth of the jungle Repterodae were covered with bone tissue to make crushing food easier. Thank you all for watching this issue to the end. Give it a thumbs up and leave a comment. Don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. And also hit the bell not to miss new and interesting releases from the channel Real Unreal.